Papa was a Rolling Stone, but now I got Rolling Stones in the bezel. Ice. Mama and home all alone.
What it do, flight crew? This week has been an interesting one, boys. My mother sold our childhood home, packing up the room, packing up the house.
This is where it really all started for me. I lived here since I was like 7.
This little trip home wasn't all sadness, though.
My Miata broke down, spent the entire week working on that.
Another cool thing I did was I went sneaker shopping at a secret sneaker store in Boston.
Like actually a secret sneaker store.
Oh my God,
that's my dog.
I hope you liked him.
Bro, did this thing really break? This thing really broke. My room is cluttered. My room is a mess. Is my head out of frame? Because I'll kill someone. Earlier in the week, I went sneaker shopping with my friends Nick and Ashley. They live in Boston.
Oh, shit.
I wanted to vlog more at the secret sneaker store that we went to, but they didn't really allow filming. Listen, man, I'm gonna be honest. I spent way too much at this sneaker store. On moms, my whole intention was to go in, just get my dad a pair of shoes, and call it quits. Little did I know, we were going to a fucking bodega. I've never been to Bodega before. I did recently take a nice L on the New Balance Bodega collab that came out. Is it cool if I sit here? Am I even in frame? Yo, if I'm not in frame. So the reason this place was a secret store was because when you walk in, it looks like a mini mart. It's like a little convenience store. Now, I was just so excited to get into the shop, I wasn't even really paying attention. When you actually pay attention to the products in the convenience store, it's like Hypebeast albums and magazines, and they have a little vending machine. And then they're selling like Bodega socks and water bottles and caution tape and all these things that like completely slipped my mind and I wasn't even paying attention. They have someone sitting at the counter that's working the convenience store. Then you've got this sliding door that opens. And before you know it, you take 3 steps in and you're in the middle of a complex sneaker shopping episode. You got a bunch of angry bodega workers saying, don't film the door. But yeah, they were actually telling everyone, like everyone's pulling out their phones to show it on Snapchat, this and that. I wasn't taking chances. They were cool with me. I wish I had the white pair to show you, but I wore them yesterday and I ruined them changing the head gasket on my Miata. But I ended up getting these cool little Bodega socks. They say Bodega on one side with a rose on the other side. I've been trying to step up my my sock game recently. I'd say I'm doing a decent job. See, this is a hit for me. I wanted to get a couple things I would remember. It's a little shirt of a little sun, says Bodega on it. A little pricey for a tee, but I mean, what are you gonna do? It's like $45. I was like, what the hell, I'll get it. So, little Bodega tee. I'm gonna be honest, boys. We got a lot of mixed reviews on my little sailor hat, my little farmer hat, my little golfer hat. I wore in my dunk video the other day. Decided to send it with a little Stussy bucket. Yo, is this a one size hat? Why is this shit so small? Yo, this is getting fucking returned. Bro, I look like one of those erasers you stick on the end of your pencil. As you guys know, my favorite color is green. Could be wrong, and my dad's not here to clarify. Pretty sure his favorite color is green as well. So like the favorite child I am, I bought us both matching shoes. Shout out my boy from Bodega. These were limited to one per person. I ended up copping a size 10 for my dad and a size 11 for me. These are the New Balance Classic Green 550s. This shoe is so clean. It's so bulky. It looks like a perfect mix of simple dad shoe that just like almost passes off as designer. I don't know if you guys rock with this. I don't know if you think it's ugly. They also had these in purple, but I mean, I had already bought 2 pairs. I wanted to get the purples as well. And then we've got the game winner. I paid $300 for fucking khakis. No, I'm just kidding. Well, no, I'm not kidding. I was shopping. I get to the Stone Island rack. I don't know what I was doing. I don't know who the fuck I thought I was pulling something off the shelf without checking the price tag first. I am not a cocky shopper that just grabs things off and is like, here's the debit card. No problem. If you ever buy pants that are $345, yo, do me a solid. Return them. They fit great. They feel great. The materials are awesome. Plus, I'll wear them. I have no good khakis. Listen, guys, I'm in the middle of a ton of moving craziness. I promise videos are going to be pumping once I'm all settled at my new place. What I've gone through this week has been so hectic and so insane. Thank you guys for all the support on my videos recently. This video means so much more to me than you guys know because this room is where it all started for me. And this is the last time I'm ever going to film in here.
And how do you feel that I spent $345 on a pair of Stone Island pants?
I put on my jewelry just to go to the bodega. And I keep it with me just so that I'm feeling safer. Fendi on my body, but my feet is in Bottega.